Amelia Earhart was and still is the greatest female aviator in history. So how is it possible that she simply vanished into thin air, never to be seen again? It's a puzzling mystery, and her story has sent hundreds of historians, analysts, emergency search crews, and governments into brick walls, wasting millions of dollars in the process. All kinds of wild theories have circulated since the disappearance, but there's one which has begun to gain serious traction. Was Amelia Earhart secretly an American spy, captured by the Japanese against her will? The evidence and the facts certainly lead us to believe that, so let's take a closer look and uncover the truth once and for all. To this day, Amelia Earhart remains a household name. Her achievements were nothing short of remarkable, setting record after record as the pioneer of female aviation. With such a high level of notoriety, when she and her navigator, Fred Noonan, simply vanished out of thin air on the 2nd of July 1937, the world instantly fell into shock. Despite the immense fame and constant media attention, authorities failed to determine what actually happened. The facts seemed clouded, and the convoluted theories were being fired off in every direction. For decades, Amelia's millions of fans were under the impression that she'd tragically perished somewhere in the Pacific Ocean. With a fuel tank running critically low, amidst uncomfortable cloud cover, and lacking high-grade emergency equipment, a full-force impact into the ocean would have been catastrophic. Considering that the Pacific stretches some 12,000 miles from the shores of South America to Asia, the wreckage could have easily drifted away. But maybe there's more to the story. Maybe she didn't perish on impact and sink to the bottom of the ocean. Perhaps the pair actually made it out alive. Some say that Amelia returned to the USA in secret. Others say that she was captured, or that she lived out her final years as a castaway. In fact, following the disappearance, radio operators in the area claimed to have received countless croaky broken calls for a number of days, coming from someone they believed could have been Amelia. Each idea has its own varying degree of merit. The theory which rings most true, however, which has been strengthened by cold hard evidence in recent years, is this one. Amelia Earhart was an elite American spy who had been taken down mid-air by the Japanese forces, held captive on one of Japan's 300 islands, and potentially used as a tool for negotiation with the US government. It's mysterious, it's got cover-up written all over it, and based on the facts that we'll touch on in a moment, it may very well be the truth. But before we skydive into the nitty-gritty of Amelia's supposed life as an undercover international spy, let's decipher how her story managed to gain so much traction over the years in the first place. Who was she? What made her so special and such a respected name? As a kid growing up in rural Kansas, Amelia always found herself exploring the outdoors. This kid was an adventurer through and through. Despite her appetite for adrenaline, it took until her 20s for Amelia to actually end up in a cockpit. In Long Beach, California, beachside of downtown Los Angeles, 23-year-old Earhart took a seat in a small racer plane alongside Frank Hawks, a famous pilot in his own right. That short time whirling through the air was all the inspiration she needed. From that moment, Amelia Earhart was hooked. She took that first flight in 1920 and declared, "As soon as we left the ground, I knew myself had to fly." After obtaining her own pilot's license, Amelia established herself as merely the 16th female in history to do so. In hindsight, not one of the other 15 would hold a legacy so beloved or famous. That's all thanks to Amelia's ambition to break records. Hey, which records? A lot. Ready? In 1922, she set the feminine altitude record of 14,000 feet. In 1931, she became the first woman to fly an autogyro, and in that same year set the autogyro altitude record of 18,415 feet. But it was her long-range flights which really etched her name into the history books, presuming, as some might think, that those history books weren't forged to cover up her espionage antics. Let's take a look, shall we? On the 20th of May, 1932, Earhart became the first woman ever to fly nonstop across the Atlantic Ocean, making it all the way from Harbor Grace in Newfoundland to Londonderry in Northern Ireland. Just 3 months later, she became the first female pilot to fly solo across America, jetting off from the West in LA and landing in New York a hasty 19 hours later. These days, it's an easy 5-hour flight that'll set you back $150. But she wasn't too interested in the finances. She was doing it out of passion. These days, pilot salaries vary according to the type of aircraft that they're flying and how long they've been at an airline. But just to give you an idea, the average American Airlines pilot yearly pay in the United States is approximately $188,898. It's substantially above the national average, 144% above to be precise, and the whole world apart from what Amelia would have made back then as a solo pilot. But it was clear, Amelia wasn't doing it for money. She was doing it out of excitement and a drive for adventure, or perhaps she was doing it because she was under strict orders from the US government. That being said, if there really is more to the story and she was an American spy, then the salary coming from either the Air Force or FBI would have been significant for her time. Now, about the notorious crash, Amelia and her navigator were en route to set another record, to be the first woman to circumnavigate the globe. After a failed attempt going west from California that had to be canned in Hawaii, Amelia gave it another go. This time, she went east, quietly making her way to Miami before taking off on her journey, a journey that made headlines on 2-cent newspapers across the country. She made stops in South America, Africa, the Indian subcontinent, and Southeast Asia before touching down in Lae in Papua New Guinea. That's right, about here. Sadly, this would be her last official runway. Howland Island would have been her final stop before heading back to Hawaii and California, but she never made it there. On July 2, 1937, as she flew toward Howland Island, the U.S. Coast Guard received a radio transmission. What was that message? "We cannot see you! Fuel is running low! Been unable to reach you by radio! We are flying at 1,000 feet! And that was the last we ever heard of this legendary aviator. An immediate $4 million search was launched to uncover answers. Ships and planes from the U.S. Navy and Coast Guard analyzed nearly 250,000 square miles of ocean. The 2-week search, commissioned by President Franklin D. Roosevelt himself, cost a whopping $4 million, and they still came up empty-handed. But perhaps there's more to the story. If the 2017 documentary by the History Channel is anything to go by, Amelia and Fred were discovered by the Japanese, then held prisoner on the island of Saipan, which was formerly under a Japanese stronghold. The documentary, as well as the increased espionage chatter, ignited as a direct result of this piece of evidence, a photo taken on Jaluit Atoll in the Marshall Islands, one which was buried deep in the National Archives for decades. At first glance, it's just a group of people standing on a dock. But go ahead, look closer. On the very right of the picture lies a blurry section which is argued to be Earhart's plane, a plane which, according to author W.C. Jameson, was equipped with cameras used to photograph the Japanese infrastructure from above, a typical spy tactic. See that person with their back turned? Investigators argue that she was the same hair length and body size as Earhart. And finally, perhaps the most critical piece of information, that person on the left side of the photo sports the same hairline and stature as Fred Noonan, the navigator. Alas, while thought-provoking, this image doesn't prove her survival beyond a shadow of a doubt. The so-called plane, highlighted on the right, is blurry and open to interpretation. Plus, according to an official report at the time, the Navy concluded that Earhart and Noonan had run out of fuel, crashed into the Pacific, and drowned. If that's true, then the photo analysts are wrong. If the photo analysts are correct, then the Navy and the government could be hiding something. Which side do you fall on? And why was it buried for so long? Makes you think, doesn't it? So, let's reiterate, the Navy officially stated that the pair was never found. Evidence unearthed by this man, Rick Gillespie, the founder of TIGHAR, says otherwise. The acronym stands for the International Group of Historic Aircraft Recovery, and they've been investigating the Earhart mystery for decades. In 1991, he and his team took a 3-week trip to Nikumararo and found a piece of an aircraft. If proven to be part of Earhart's Lockheed, it could have sold for hundreds of thousands of dollars to museums, if not more. On future visits, Rick found sections of a jar reminiscent of the ones used to hold Dr. Barry's freckle ointment, a brand Amelia regularly carried with her. Most notable wasn't the contents, but the locations in which the glass fragments were found. 4 of the 5 shards were together in one spot. The 5th, however, was discovered near the bones of a turtle about 65 feet away, suggesting it may have been used as a food prepping knife. If we put the 2 pieces of the puzzle together, the photo from Jaluit Atoll and Rick Gillespie's evidence, we start to get a better idea of the reality. Earhart could have crashed on Nikumararo. The Japanese would have retrieved her from that island and transported her between Jaluit Atoll and Saipan. But then what? From there, it could have gone in one of 2 directions. The first, she remained alive over in the remote Pacific Islands, held under control of the Japanese. She could very well have lived out on the islands, eventually integrating within the local society. That's assuming she was eventually released by her captors. The second, and the alternative, is that she moved back to the USA at the beginning of the 1970s. Many have proposed that a New Jersey woman named Irene Bolam was Earhart in disguise, but Irene denied this until her final breath in 1982. W.C. Jameson wrote in his book titled Amelia Earhart, Beyond the Grave, that within circles of the U.S. Army officials, Earhart was considered verbatim involved in an intelligence gathering operation. Then, of course, there's the idea of life as a castaway. A skull was found on Nicomoraro Island. After all, we can't forget the wilder theories surrounding alien abduction, but we're obviously not too concerned with those. So with all these puzzle pieces of information, where does your opinion fall? Do you think that she was a US spy deliberately sent to Japan by an agency like the CIA to scour information? Or was she captured and sent back to America to gather information for the Japanese? Maybe the plane crash was just a cover-up, and the $4 million search issued by Roosevelt nothing more than a facilitated media announcement. It wouldn't be the first time the governments have twisted the facts, but we'll never know for sure. So we'll leave it up to you to decide what really happened to Amelia, Fred, and that Lockheed Electra. Share your thoughts in the comments below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and as always, thanks for watching. Catch you next time.